Hey guys, it is SuperR501, or as I go by now, Michael Mega X. Welcome to Let's Play Through History. Been a while, hasn't it? Almost a whole year since I've last uploaded a video. But I thought I would get back into it now for fun with Star Wars Battlefront 2 Galactic Conquest, because the upcoming release of the new Star Wars film and Star Wars Battlefront is coming out soon, and I thought, why not go back and play some Battlefront 2 for fun? So I thought I'd do a Galactic Conquest as the Republic, because I love the clones, and that's probably like my favorite era, so let's get started into it.
All fleets on standby.
Alright, so if you don't know what it is, this is Galactic Conquest, where you play as each different faction, and you try to conquer the galaxy, and you get these little fleets that are placed. And what you do, like, you go around the galaxy like a game board, and your objective is to capture all the planets by winning each battle. I just recently did a video of this, but for some reason my sound just randomly went out, and I had to redo this. So I think I'll start off by saving up some credits to buy the Clone Commander. And since we're right next to it, I think we can go for a Tatooine victory.
Commencing Tatooine invasion.
I'm not gonna go to Geonosis yet because, I don't know, I don't really want to go to it. Even though it's like right next to here. So I'll probably be switching off between third and first person while playing this. Just depending on what my mood is, because right now I'm in an FPS mood. By the way, if you've never played this game, which most of you probably have if you're watching this video, it is just amazing. I used to play this game all the time on my PlayStation, and I only recently got on PC. So I thought, hey, why not record some gameplay? Easier to record on PC. And will give me a good idea for a Let's Play Through History. Also earlier during the year, I was trying to make a Let's Play Through History of some other games and like an update video on why I decided to change my name and whatnot. And kind of like expand my channel a little bit, but I'll try to do that update again at some point. But this game is amazing, and I got them. It's just so fun. Spent many a days playing it on the PlayStation 2 in my childhood. Also, I have I changed the Clone Trooper skins from second generation to first, because I like the first generation look of the Clone Troopers more.
Hostiles have gained a command post.
So, what do you get? There's different awards in this game if you don't know. I guess I can't jump over that. There we go. Different awards in this game, so I just got 12 kills with a blaster rifle. It gave me an award blaster rifle, which is which will just be a more powerful version. 3-round burst. Well, I already had. And it's amazing. Alright, let's see if we can't get this command post up here. Hopefully the quality isn't gonna look too bad. My computer, for how crappy it is, was actually recording in above 60 FPS earlier. Probably because of this game, it doesn't take too much to record. Since it's so old. 10 years, I believe, this game is. Oops. Okay, good. I didn't blow myself up.
The command post has been lost, but not the battle. The
Seriously?
Post has been lost, but not
Another
the battle.
One? Good thing I'm being this one. Alright, they're not doing anything. Oh, nice drifting kill.
The enemy has taken a command post.
Set him up and knock him down.
Hostiles have gained a command post. Our second wave of troops is being depleted.
See, 67 to 30. All right, we're doing pretty good. Should I try? I'm gonna see if I can get the Gunslinger award real quick. You can always use more wards, because getting back up to legendary status will get you automatically with the award before you start the... Oh no, come on. Oh no, I'm overrated! Will automatically get you the award before you start the game. So if I have legendary on Frenzy, which is both kills with the... blaster rifle, I'll have the award rifle from the start. I think I'll be able to do two or three battles in one video, hopefully, depending on how long they take. Yep, they're all in turrets. But we won! So it doesn't matter. I wonder if you can hear the popping of my knuckles after that.
The Republic has grudgingly accepted credits for conquering Tatooine.
Oh, right, Naboo. I was like, which planets do we have? It was kind of really hard to see right there. Ooh, it looks like they already purchased the Leer bonus, but it'll be to no effect here. Pop a little space battle. One of the best parts about the game.
Clear the hangar area. Repeat, clear the hangar area.
Now you could do the obvious bomber run, or you could do anything else, but I'll do. Choose a bomber and take out all their ships and critical systems and whatnot. Oh god. They're already... Yeah, tongue-tied. They're already shooting me from that distance. So I'll just take out the frigate ships, and I should be good.
Fire.
Some people might argue that space battles are really boring, but I always find they're the best part about Star Wars Battlefront 2. Their frigates destroyed. Alright, I'm gonna go cause some trouble in their hangar.
Enemy bombers are incoming. Repeat, enemy bombers are incoming.
Our shields have been disabled.
Attack that bomber!
Right now I'm playing on normal difficulty, so they're not gonna bother going for me that much. Space battle is probably the easiest way for you to get to gunslinger and whatnot. So I think I'll just destroy their life support system.
Systems have been destroyed.
And move on to the engines.
One for the Republic.
Or not. We're done here. Alright, I think that'll do it for this episode. On the next episode, we'll be moving more around the map, and I will see you guys later.